Hi, I'm Susanna, and I'm a product owner here at Pressler. And today I'm going to show you how to configure PRTG in order to use our Microsoft Azure Storage Account sensor. In order to use the Microsoft Azure Storage Account sensor, you need to add a device in PRTG. So I add a device. I need to give my device a name. In this case, I will name it Azure Storage Account. Then I leave the next setting as it is. As a DNS name, I will just give localhost. And then the next thing you need to do is scroll down until you find credentials for Microsoft Azure. And you enable it, and you see you need to put in four different pieces of information. And to get this information, you need to do some configuration in the Azure portal. So let's take a look. I am now in the Azure portal, and I need to create a new app registration. So I go into App Registrations, and I click on New Registration. I need to give my registration a name. So in this case, PRTG Azure Sensors. The rest of the settings can stay the same. And in the end, you're asked to enter a redirect URI. If you have one available, then you can use your own. Otherwise, you can use the following. Login.windows.net. Then you click on register. Now you have successfully created an app registration. And as you can see here on the overview page, you can get two pieces of information. So application or client ID and directory or tenant ID. And both of these informations are needed in PRTG configuration. So I will go ahead and copy them. So I copied first the tenant ID, then the client ID. And as we can see here, the next thing we need is the client secret. So I go back to my Azure portal and I navigate to certificates and secrets. There, I need to create a new client secret. So I will click on the new client secret button and I need to give my client secret a name. So in this case, I will name it PRTG Azure Sensor Secret. And I will set the expiry date to the default of 6 months, but you can change it to your liking. So I click on Add. And here I can see my Azure, my new client secret. You can now also see the token for the secret, and I will copy it immediately and put it into PRTG. Make sure you do that immediately. So either copy it into PRTG or copy it to a local file. Because once you leave the page in the Azure portal, then the token will disappear and you won't be able to see it again. So I will just directly paste it in PRTG. And the last thing I need is a subscription ID. So there I go again into the Azure portal. I go to home and I click on subscriptions. There, I select the subscription to which my storage account belongs to that I want to monitor. And then I navigate to access control. So the first thing I need to do is create a custom role. So I go to add custom role. And there, as you can see, you're asked to fill in some information. So there's two ways to do it. Either you do it manually, or there's an easier way. You can quickly go to our knowledge base article called How Do I Obtain Credentials and Create Custom Roles for the Microsoft Azure Sensors? And there, you just scroll to the bottom. Yeah, where you find the JSON structure. And you can take this JSON structure and save it to a local file in your local directory and then upload it into the Azure portal, and then the information will fill in automatically. Since I've already done that, I will just quickly go and upload it. So here in baseline permissions, you click on start from JSON. Then you're asked to select a file. So you click on select. And then you find your file. Then I click on open. And as you can see, all the information has been automatically filled in. There's only one action missing, and you can see that from the red dot. So I click on assignable scopes and I click on add assignable scopes. And as a scope, I give the subscription that I'm in. And then the last thing you need to do is review and create. And once you've reviewed and the information is correct, then you click on create. Now I have successfully created a custom role. So the last thing you need to do is create the role assignment, which means you need to assign the role you have just created to the app registration you created a few minutes ago. So to do that is I go to add and then go to add role assignment. I select for the role I just created. The assign access to field stays as it is. And for select, you go to PRTG Azure Center. So the app registration you created a few minutes ago. And you click on OK on the app registration, and then you click on Save. All right, so now we successfully added a new role assignment. So all we need to do is go to Overview and get the subscription ID. So I copy it and put it into PRTG. That's a configuration you need in both the Azure portal and PRTG in order to get the sensor working. So I click on OK. And then I click on Add Sensor. So I need to find the sensor. And there you can see all the storage account instances that we have created in the Azure portal. So you can select all of them or whichever ones you want to monitor. And for each one that you select, you get a sensor for each instance. In our case, I will just go ahead and create them all. Then click on Create. And there you go. Then you can get information regarding your Azure storage account. You get information regarding the average e-tweet latency, the number of request breakdowns, storage latency, total egress and total ingress, and the used capacity. And yeah, that's all you need to know in order to use our Azure storage account sensor. I hope you found this tutorial helpful. If so, please like and subscribe. If you have any new topics or new things you would like us to do a tutorial about, please feel free to put it in the comments. If you need help with PRTG, you can contact our support at our website. Have a nice day and thanks for watching.